So I would probably like to start by a bit of my background. I did my undergraduate in computer science from a college in India, but then I was like, I want to do something more socially applicable. And Duke kind of offered me one of the best programs at the intersection of economics and computer science. And it also provided me an opportunity to interact with brilliant students around. It's an amazing cohort to be with. And I was like, Duke is the place to go, definitely.
I come from a background that was not very quantitative. I studied international relations in my undergrad, and I was looking for a program that would be rigorous to prepare for my PhD and that would teach me quantitative skill that I was absolutely lacking.
During my undergrad study, I read a lot of papers from Journal of Financial Econometrics, and I saw the Professor Tim Bursiv and Professor Andrew Patton are very popular in that field. They are actually the world experts in volatility estimation and high-frequency data analysis. So that drives me to apply for Duke for further academic development.
So the campus is gorgeous, and when you come and you stand here on campus, it's like, wow, this is Duke University. Like, if I have an opportunity to be here, I want to take it. The other big thing that I'd like to mention is the flexibility of the classes that you have here. You've got a couple required classes, but then it's really, what are you interested in? What do you want to do? Go take those classes. Go figure out what it is that you like.
Well, there's only a couple of prestigious programs that are terminal masters in economics. Duke is one of them. It's one of the few programs that actually has a nice balance between statistics and computer science, that when you pair it up with economics, it gives you a very interesting profile, which is very attractive for either academia or industry.
So at Duke, I found a really nice group of friends across the years, both within my cohort, the year above, the years below. I think we built a pretty nice community, and I enjoyed that a lot from, say, the social point of view. But also, once I came here, I realized how supportive also the professors were to the students. And my advisors in particular, I have two advisors from my program, and they were just amazing, really always open to questions, always happy to meet me, happy to hear my research ideas. And then I also found two more professors who I could do research with, whose interests really intersected with mine really well. And that just made my experience here so much better. I really felt like my ideas mattered. People were actually listening to my academic views. So that was great.
Honestly, the things that I've enjoyed most about the experience are my classes. They've all been challenging and difficult in their own ways. You have to be prepared to work to be successful, but if you are prepared to work, you can get a lot out of them. The professors really want you to learn. They want you to ask questions. I've had professors send me multiple page emails about a question I asked in class, just wanting to clarify the points that they made.
MQAFE program, we have a very small cohort, and we have 9 students, 6 professors. Each student can get a lot of individual attention from our war expert professors.
I'm reminded of 3 experiences which I had at Duke. First one comes from my course with Professor Vincent Connors, who is a professor of computer science and economics at Duke. I worked on this course on computational microeconomics with him. The course kind of paved my future way in an interest in doing PhD in network theory and economics. I guess that kind of defines now what I will be doing in future. The second experience comes from taking an undergraduate class on discrete mathematics. So while you're taking an undergraduate class, which is approximately 150 to 200 students, you have to manage a team of approximately 8 to 10 undergrad TAs. This is not only an opportunity to learn how to teach students, but this is actually an opportunity to understand how to manage a team, how to act efficiently with deadlines. The last one is kind of a bit of fun experience where we went to Duke Marine Lab in Beaufort during a seafood festival and kind of tasted crabs. This was my first time tasting crabs. They were delicious. And then we played beach volleyball and had a bit of snorkeling experience over there. It was really amazing.
There's also this Duke culture. When it's basketball season, it's pretty easy to get all excited. It's very competitive and entertaining, so you pick up on the Duke basketball culture pretty fast.
The people here are great. You will have to work with people in your classes. You will not succeed on your own. So finding people who can help share the burden is a big thing. And what I've found here is that everybody's willing to work. Everybody who makes it this far is a good student. They're very bright, and they want to learn and succeed just as much as you do.
If it was possible for you to come up with some career goal in mind before you enter the program, it would be really beneficial for you because you can then design the curriculum according to your needs. For example, I was interested in applying machine learning in economics, and so I did courses like machine learning, artificial intelligence, reinforcement learning, along with which I did courses in economics on macro theory, and econometrics. So it kind of allows you to add your flavor to the kind of curriculum you want to have.
My greatest advice is don't care about grades that much. I feel people here oftentimes just think about their grades and forget what their passions are. They forget why they came here, why they want to be social scientists. So I would recommend you go back to what really drives you, what your passions are. And I'm sure that at Duke there's going to be somebody who's interested in exactly the same thing you can work with, and that's just going to make your life so much better.
For students who are planning to attend, prepare for a fast-paced study environment and get familiar with coding as early as possible.
Just have fun. Make sure you're happy with every decision you're making. Take advantage of the Duke network. Leverage all the past classes. Make sure to contact them if you have any questions. I'm sure they're going to be happy to help.